like, oh my God, wait, where am I? Like, I feel like I should still be at your house.
Wow, that was, wow, thank you guys so much. That was so much fun. Hello again.
I mean, first of all, look around you. Like, what does this mean to you?
It's, I mean, it's epic, you know?
I have a little bit of laryngitis, but I'll be
right. It's, you know, Mark and I, when we first worked on Vicious Circle and then Isolated Incident, it was almost like we just didn't want to come together again until we knew that it was something that was in the never been done before business. And I'm so proud of this. Thank you. Thanks, Marty.
Thank you.
So now I have some really hard-hitting journalistic questions for everybody. Okay. We're going to get serious. No, I'm just kidding.
The hardest part was seeing my big Irish head even bigger on that screen.
So, above it all, where did you come up with the title?
I think, I mean, it really was indicative of the look, that beautiful location, and then, you know, the idea that 31 years into a career, not allowing those moments where you feel like it's a capsizing moment, and not letting even some of the overtop, overwhelming moments take you away from the reality, which is it's all about the fans. It's all about making something funny to make people laugh, and then that'll bring me joy. So that's it. Staying above all the bullshit.
I love that you said that. And then, of course, what did I do backstage? I started Googling myself. But you compared it to, like, cutting yourself. So do you ever secretly Google yourself?
Well, I learned years ago, I said, you know, one time I went to Google myself, and Google said, are you sure?
that's
a hard no. Yes, absolutely. Try to stay away from Googling myself.
So it's filmed at your home, which, I mean, obviously you're not going to share your address with the Hollywood Hills area. So, did people know they were coming to your house?
Actually, you know what? People were shuttled to the event. They didn't know it was us filming. They didn't know it was at my home. And one guy at the end of the night came up and he threw a hug on me and said, man, I'm so glad this was actually a show because when we were going through the hills, I thought I was being human trafficked. No one
called.
It was like once Marty and I got up there on Friday, and he just kind of gave me permission to lean into the work. He'd come see me do so many sets at the club locally, and just reminded me that even though it's a unique location and event in the evening, to just be the storyteller that you trusted that I could be. That was it.
I remember Dane, we were on this app.
I scoped the premises at the end of that first night, just wondering, okay, was somebody like this, you know, stuck around the backside?
You did show your refrigerator.
I did, yeah. There was people, I think they're here tonight too, that were like, you know, we always wanted to meet you, but we saw you post your refrigerator online, and we take a picture with it. So my fridge was actually more popular in some ways.
Like a vending machine.
Your fridge is such a reflection of who you are as a person.
Capri Sun.
Yeah, so now I got what's in your fridge. What's your drink of choice in your fridge?
You know, here's the thing. I worked at a convenience store when I was a kid, and it was more just about, like, I had to marry the label. That was my job, to go and make sure everything. So my fridge is more about, like, I'll get the purple Fanta, not because I want to drink it, but just aesthetically it looks nice in there, the color palette. Yeah.
I love that. What's your charcuterie situation? That's my next question. The helicopter noises. I mean, you kind of turned it into a part of the show with the jokes. Like, I'm assuming that was not planned.
Yeah, no, it was like, what do I do, Marty, if that?
I'm the same.
Yeah.
So he turned it into a comedy bit. I always like improv. I always think that's when people are top of their game. And he certainly accomplished that.
It was really just about the comedy I grew up loving. And what I've always appreciated about what Marty has captured so unbelievably is seeing a comedian that's prepared, has their set, but just fucking lets it go and allows people in to see something uniquely different for that one unique show. And I was so amazed after that first night that we felt like we were on that track.
I call that happy accident.
I was kind of waiting for Tom Cruise to drop out. Anybody else? I don't know. I was like, who's up there?
I believe he's busy.
I also think your five things to date somebody, right? What are they?
Mindful, thoughtful, compassionate, and collaborative, and caring.
I want to know how you came up with that, because I actually watched that about 10 times to think about it. It's in my name.
I came up with it because once I met Kelsey, I realized those were the boxes that I wanted to have checked, and I wanted to be able to also participate in the relationship. You know, when you have somebody incredible by your side like that, then mindful, thoughtful, compassionate, collaborative, and caring, you want to be what you're receiving. Moments like that, and I hope from this as well. It's just a testament. welcome, Marty.
Where are you, baby?
I love that, because that was true. Every single person. I don't think there's one person that gets a wedding invitation. It's like, oh my God, hey, can I travel? And I think that made me laugh. I think that's
cool. Okay. Good.
Do you have people that slide into your DMs, too, about, like, old jokes? And what's the one that gets brought up the most?
Oh, boy.
Who slides into your DMs?
Yeah, who slides into your DMs? That's a great question.
I'm trying to think of, like, you know, there's one. Well, because we're coming here, the movie theater bit that we did from that special as well from Vicious, you know, people were writing me, and a lot of people that are here tonight were, you know, again, sharing their favorite lines from the movie theater bit, saying, I'm going to get my tea, just the cheese, please. And I was getting that all day long.
You know, you talk about you were a billionaire and lonely. So, how do you feel now? How do you describe yourself now?
You just upgraded me to a billionaire?
Can you think you're a billionaire?
Wow, are we doing well already? I thought we were only in one theater for one night. Shit. Yeah, this is all out of my own pocket, so actually, it's if anybody wants to throw a few bucks in the can on the way out, I might be able to afford it.
You don't feel that way about yourself anymore, though, now that you're with
Kelsey. Hey, you know what? I'm a welfare kid from outside of Boston, Massachusetts, who dreamed a big dream, and my mom said, don't ever fucking let anybody get in the way of it. Go for it. I'm behind you 100%. And, you know, I'm a person sitting here as somebody proof positive that if you just, you know, dig deep and put in the 10,000 hours that you can possibly be sitting here in this beautiful
location.
I mean, most of it is just, you know, like I said, when Marty came down and saw me, I was like, these are things that I've kind of collected and, you know, have happened to me and observed and reported. You know, that's the best kind of comedy and storytelling. And you're in a moment and then you're finding those LPMs, those laughs per minute. But most of it just comes from experiences that you go through or everything in here. The stalker stuff is, and that's the condensed version of the story. And the Rathskeller, you know, that entire early moment of my life where it's like, man, if I can't make a few people laugh at a college gig and get hot dogs thrown at me, it's like, these are all moments that I felt like reflect my life, but also great, funny, you know, possibilities within those confines of the story.
How much material did not, well, obviously a whole nother special didn't make it, but
yeah.
how long did you film for?
Well, the second show was 2.5 hours. The first night was 1.5 hours. And so the second show just ran 1 hour, you know, probably about another 1.5 hours of stuff that I think is, you know, that I'd like to share, right?
Yeah, why not? Great.
If he says it, then, okay. If he said I already deleted it, keep working on it, kid, I'd be like, all right, back to the fucking clubs. Let me.
It was tough to choose, believe me. It was very difficult.
Slide into his DM. What's your Instagram though, Marty? How did you guys decide what to actually include and what to leave out?
You really just told me to go for it. That first night you said just air it out, have the time of your life. I remember that the weather leading up was not great, and then that Friday night you finally got that beautiful quintessential sunset.
I actually asked to do more. The more the better. Because when I got to edit it, and I never know what's going to work and what's not going to work, but it all worked. So I had, you know, a difficult time, but he just kept going. Could have kept going forever as far as I'm
concerned. So I know having the premiere is really important to you to do it here. What makes this place so special? I mean, it's iconic, but why here?
Well, you know, I want to create moments, and I feel like I've had the opportunity to create moments with Marty in my career that are in the never been done before business. And I like to be a bit of a disruptor. I like to do things against the grain. even within this community, and sometimes the right people come together to believe your impossible idea, where you're like, could we do something like this here? So we got the right technology to film it on the cameras to be able to upscale it to an incredible moment, evening like this.
And it drops tomorrow.
Yes!
Wow. It drops tomorrow, tell all your friends. On Moment, which is a platform. So why did you decide to go to platformer rather than take it to, a network that we want to make?
Yeah, I mean, without being too, in the weeds about it, I just love that, we live in an era where young artists can control their content. Sometimes you get into a contract that unfortunately it just embroils you in years of maybe not having that ability to shift and go, no, I think my stuff belongs over here. So Moment came to us and said, how do you want to roll it out? How do you want to, participate with your fans? And I just enjoyed having the IP be mine to then say in a few months, Marty, where do you, take this?
Well, they're really smart, okay? And they don't meddle, and they don't censor. So I think it's a good paradigm myself.
And can we expect you guys to be working together again soon after this?
They say yes? Okay. I mean, Marty is, guys, this is the legend. This man is like, it's rare to be able to share time with him and call him a friend, but to have been able to watch how he works and then how he ushered me forward in my own career and helped put me on the map and helped me stay on the map. It's like, what can you say? He's the best. You're looking at one of the best right now.
And before we wrap up here, where can people download or stream Moment? Because I didn't even know. I would love to hear from you.
Yeah, they just go to moment.co. That's it. It's all on there. Or they can go to danecook.com and it'll swing you right over to their link.
That's easy. What's next for you? Where can people catch you performing? What do you want to do?
Yeah, next up is, we're still editing this, the sequel of this, and then we're going to do a documentary. I'm working on a documentary with a couple of friends of mine, and it's going to be pretty wild. Very good. Funny, but pretty wild.
There'll be blood everywhere.
Thank you.